going to sit this side.
I do normally go that side.
It's a bit Anton deck, isn't it?
What, are you Ant or are you Dick?
I don't know which is which, anyway.
Can we be neither? Can't we be somebody else? All right, okay. Hi, we've started, Roger. I didn't realise. Camera's running.
Oh, dear.
Breaking news. I've got a new jacket.
Have you?
So, the old light and grey two-tone jacket with the red trim.
Yes.
Gone. Ow. Retired. We've already recorded one video this morning. We've got another request, Dobbs, but this video is coming up before, so we've recorded them out of order. Okay. So pretend like we haven't been to those request stops yet. We're going to Britain's newest railway station. Roger. Sorry. Go on. What
didn't we do this morning then?
The request stop video.
Oh, right.
Which will be out after this video.
No. Okay.
This is just a minute of waffle at the beginning. I can't use this.
No, you can't. Start again.
I'm totally using this. Where are we going?
Inverness Airport, Britain's latest, newest station.
Yes, Britain's newest station, a 10-minute ride one stop east from Inverness, opened on the 2nd of February. It's on the Inverness to Aberdeen line, where you'll recall another new station, Kintore, also opened recently.
And welcome to Britain's newest railway station, Inverness Airport. Although, as we'll see in a minute, I was here last night and Roger also flew in yesterday. But you were just having a quick count of people with bags.
10 people, and they've all just walked past the bus stop. And there is, in fact, a bus due in 9 minutes. But it's not entirely clear where you go to walk.
We already knew in advance that this was going to be like a cut and paste station. In fact, I can't remember who it was. In my six station steers last year, was it Carl or was it Jen or was it? Might have been Lewis actually.
All right.
Somebody said it's a cut and paste station. Yes. And then someone came up with the expression cookie cutter. It's like a cookie cutter station.
Right, right.
So to that end, Roger, I have brought.
Oh, wow.
I have brought some cookie cutters.
Oh, wow.
So at the end of the video, when you get to the airport, you're going to award the cookie cutters
to the modular
aspects of the new station.
Yeah, then we could go and build them elsewhere. We'll know exactly how to do it with these.
Is there a ticket machine?
Indeed there is. We're standing in front of it.
Isn't there a footbridge with lifts?
There is. It's a standard footbridge with lifts.
Are there two platforms?
There are two platforms.
Is there a car park with EV charging?
There is a car park with EV charging and one car in it at the moment, which isn't bad.
And there are dot matrix displays.
And there are dot matrix displays.
But it is extremely, hold them up,
cookie cutter.
I've never been so excited by seeing a bus before. What number is it?
On it. It's en route number 11.
Where does it go?
Which goes from here into Inverness, but at one end is extended into Nairn.
But there's no specific shuttle bus. You're relying on the scheduled bus service.
Yes, every 2 an hour.
So you might as well just walk.
Yes, in fact everyone has. Ten people have walked.
We're going to time the walk, obviously, later. Do you want to get up on your phone and just see how long Google think the walk takes? And while you do that, I'm just going to say that I've noted that not only is there no train timetable, there's no bus timetable either. So Scott Rail, hi, could you put up some timetables please so that we know if it's hourly or 2 hourly or whatever.
Google reckons it's 20 minutes.
No way.
But they think it's round the road.
They haven't worked out that you can go via the footpath. Roger, sir, I'm gonna do a cut.
And here comes the next two buses.
I'm gonna do a cutaway.
And here's that cutaway to show that yes, if you go by the road, it takes 20 minutes, but a brand new tarmac, so it's good for rolling suitcases, footpath has been built, and we're gonna time it later to see how long it takes to walk from the station to the terminal building.
Oh, thank you so much.
Now, I was actually here last night. You were here yesterday afternoon.
Yes.
I did the walk after you. I did the walk from the airport to the station in the dark. So actually, I have an idea of how long it takes. And it was well lit. The path was lit.
Yes.
Here's last night. I think the path starts here. Now, it is lit up. There's these lights at the side. But I'm using my map on my phone because there is absolutely no signage. Zero signage. I'm glad the path is lit, although I'm still quite dark. Ah, double arrows there. Station there.
There are a couple of signs here at the station telling you there's a footpath to the airport. They don't very well sign which actual footpath to take or where to go. But at the airport, there's absolutely nothing at all.
Please put more signage in. I also noticed there's a sign over there saying you're on CCTV. Someone on Twitter said there's 97 CCTV cameras here. Also, then what happened to me last night is platform one and platform two, and you naturally assume this used to be a single track, they've now doubled it. Platform one is for Aberdeen bound trains and platform two is for Inverness bound trains. I was on this platform last night on platform two, and the Inverness bound train came in on platform one, and I had to run over the footbridge and catch it.
Oh, it's just doing it again.
Oh, it's like, as it's doing now. What? That's unplanned. Look at that. It's on.
And it stopped right down the far end.
Why would trains not run through on this side?
And there's a bus, so that anybody getting off the
it's
train
literally
just missed the bus.
Then that's stopping quite a way down. And I had to run down these steps last night and run along the platform, and I only just made it. ScotRail, why aren't you stopping the trains further down, and why on the wrong side? I'd like to know. But that makes me wonder, if you live in Inverness, you might just get the taxi or the bus anyway. Might Inverness station be more useful to Aberdeen passengers? Because the station for Aberdeen Airport is Dice.
Yes.
But if you're flying, if you're going home from, say, London to Aberdeen, might a better way to go now to be to fly from Gatwick to Inverness Airport and then get the train down towards...
It may well be. But
so the advantage of Inverness Airport is that it's now really handy to get to Aberdeen.
Inverness Airport Station.
Station.
Yeah.
Is that Aberdeen people might now use it more.
Yes. Well, interestingly, there were 8 off that train that's just come from Aberdeen, but there were 10 off our train that's just come from Inverness. I think you may be right. I think the Aberdeen direction may well be proved more popular.
Bin bags not blowing in the breeze.
Ah, well.
It is extremely modular. It's just like Kintore. It's on the line. I did the station. Kintore is down the line from last year. It's almost identical to Kintore.
Because 42 million was the total project.
For the whole line. Yes. This station alone was just 14 million, which is about half of the course now. Yeah. This is what 14 million
especially two platforms.
Gets you, okay. Yes. And it's roughly an hourly service, although annoyingly they're not at the same minutes past the hour, so you do have to check the timetable. Okay. Nice view of the station behind me from the footbridge, from where you can also get a good view of the airport. Plane spotters, come and stand on the footbridge at the new station. I've been chatting to Stuart, my friend, website and Twitter on screen now, from every station, who we spoke to at Reston. Stuart has texted me because I asked about why trains come in on the other platform. He says, the thing with Inverness station is that it's future-proofed. Thanks for this, Stuart. There's a new town that's being built called Torregrain. Thank you. That will bring large numbers of potential passengers, and the doubling of the track here is to allow for higher service frequency in the future. There are also potential plans to relocate the airport terminal building, which as we know is about 15 minutes over there, to the station side of the airport as part of the airport's 25-year development plan. So Inverness Airport Station is very much built with the future in mind. Thanks, Stuart. And I can see Roger down there, so we're going to go for a walk to the station, to the airport, and time it. Before I do, I'm going to record a separate piece here. I've just counted about how many current stations there are, and people always ask me about future stations. So in the description later on, there will be a link to how many stations there are in the future and a short video I've made on that. And with that video done, let's walk to the airport. All right, we're going to go, we're timing. Let's walk, okay. Go to the airport. Almost at station again. Okay, admittedly, the wind, we did just find a temporary sign, but we're going at a Roger walking speed. I could walk a little bit faster, but
you're younger than me.
Allegedly, but we'll take your speed to be the average.
Yeah, well, you want an average.
The average walking speed.
All right. We're still going quite quick for an average person.
I'm going at your pace, Roger. And Roger's got the stopwatch. Are you ready?
Ready.
Are you ready? Tell you what, the moment you put your hand on the door.
Okay.
Put your hand on the door. And stop.
13 minutes 15 seconds, just under.
13:15.
And that was quite a pace, actually, I have to say. Quite a pace. Okay. I reckon it's 15 minutes for the average person. And that's from platform one. If you platform two, add another couple of minutes on, 17.
End of video. We're checked in. We made it. Thanks for Inverness Scottish things.
Thank you.
I believe you've got your four awards.
Yep. The circle.
It was kind of a cloud.
Cloud. Yes. That would be for the shelters on both platforms and the seating in them, and indeed the four seats.
Very, very cookie cutter.
Yeah. Very, very much.
The circular cookie cutter.
The circular cookie cutter would be for the dot matrix signs. Then the star would be for the bus shelter outside. The electric, the EV points in the car park.
Yeah. And then the heart.
What we love is, of course, the footbridge, which is fully accessible because it's got two lifts. And in the old days, you'd never bother with lifts on a station like that. But now there are proper lifts, and so it's accessible for all.
And it's good that that's cookie cutter. So that's a good cookie cutter. Because we want all new stations to have that.
And that's partly why new stations do cost a lot more now, because lifts are expensive to put in. But it's good that the rail industry is now doing that. Good.
That's it. Another station ticked off. What's next? Marsh Barton? Portway Parkway, Brent Cross.
Big argument. No, I don't
Thanet
know.
Parkway.
Reading Green Park. I think it's, who knows?
We'll be there. He won't be there. I might be there. We'll see. You'll go anyway, whatever.
I'll go on my own.
Like and subscribe, Roger.
Oh, like and subscribe, please. Yes, down below.
Read Roger's blog.
And subscribe, like,
Bye.
Didn't we do bye already?
That's in the other video.
Oh, yes.
Which you haven't published yet.
Oh, no, sorry. There isn't another video that we've just said goodbye in. Right, come on, let's go to those request stops and film that now.